scent of fall is definitely in our home, and we're checking off another item from our fall harvest bucket list with Shirley's incredible potpourri. Shirley, you have outdone yourself yet again.
I just gotta keep upping the ante all the time. Thank you, Cam.
Look at this.
It's fun. Well, potpourri. This is our fall-autumn potpourri, and what I love about making potpourri is that it's a multi-sensory act. It's like you're taking a look at beautiful elements.
Yes.
Visually, the dried plants need to look good together. The other thing is, take a whiff. It's gotta smell good, so you get to blend your own scents, or you can buy a blend of oil that's already been pre-mixed for you.
Man, oh man, and I get to try and make some more. I've done this a little bit before with you,
yeah,
but never like this. So what are we gonna do here first, Cheryl?
Okay, well, what we're gonna do first is you got to get a hold of your material. So that's dried flowers and plants. So take a walk around your neighborhood, and then you're going to want to dry it, or you can go to your craft store and buy some. But I want you to notice something.
Yep.
When you dry your flowers at home, they're going to look like this, which is pretty. But then you ask, why is the potpourri so bright like this? This is
super direct, colorful,
right?
All the time.
When you buy it at the store, and that's because they've enhanced their dried flowers, and that's what I'm going to teach you guys how to do today.
What?
Right. Okay, so we're going to start
Good.
With one.
Here we go.
Take a look at the hydrangea. This is natural. Look at this beautiful cherry, black cherry color, and I have one that's kind of purplish. This is the perfect color, I think, for the season, for autumn, because it looks good with brown
and
orange,
amazing.
Right?
And also the colors aren't like, it's sort of natural looking. It's not
right.
Like overdone a little bit. Okay, so
Absolutely.
What do we got?
Okay, so I'm gonna show you the technique. I'm not gonna do the whole thing.
Yeah.
But you always shake your can, and this is a special paint for flowers. So you wanna do, right? Okay, you get far away, and then you do little spurts like this, and you keep it
Yes.
painting. That way you can control how dark or light it is. And
Okay.
Cam, I've got an assignment for you.
Yeah, this guy.
Oh, you got it. That's the lamb's ear. Look at that, guys. Isn't that beautiful? He's gonna
Okay.
make that peach. So go ahead, do what
Shirley, you had me at spray paint for flowers. Like, I mean, that's
Oh, yeah?
Kind of cool.
Are
I'm
you
telling
a tagger?
You right now, this,
you...
is a, this is pretty awesome.
Yeah.
I like how subtle it is, too. That's probably why. Oh my gosh, I am.
Are you having a hard time?
I am. No,
Ooh,
what do you mean am I having a hard time?
Artist.
That is amazing.
I'm giving you credit.
Wow.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah,
Look,
that's
guys,
cool.
So the thing is, keep it turning when you are spraying it.
Yes.
And as you can see, it's getting there. Now the other thing, let me see yours. Status.
Yes,
Cam, you're,
surely.
You're spraying too much.
Wait, what do you mean?
No,
it looks
you're
amazing.
It's not Pam. It's not oiling a pan.
Listen,
you got to go a little spurt.
Let's move on.
Okay,
Shirley.
Let's move
I'm
on.
I'm very happy with
okay.
how I did it.
Now, I want you
Thank
guys
you
to notice. I'm proud of you too. Okay, how about our leaves
yep.
that we dry? They
Great.
Tend to dry and get dull. So here's a magnolia leaf, natural, and this
yep.
one that's been enhanced. And also, oh. I enhanced the back color. As you can see, they're two-tone, and this is the one that we've done. So all you do, guys, to preserve and enhance,
yes.
mix up some Mod Podge with some dark green.
Okay.
Make sure you don't load your brush too much. And then it's as simple as just brushing it on. And then when it dries, Cam, if you want to, you could do a second coat. But what you don't want to do is you don't want to have a lot of paint marks. You know, the brush marks,
right.
then that looks fake.
No, because the ones that were done there look really good.
Isn't that pretty?
And you
yeah.
want to be able to see the texture of the leaf through,
exactly.
right?
Yep.
Listen to me, man. I'm
look
like, I'm all
you,
into this.
You
like,
sound
I'm
like
not
you know what
mess
you're talking
around
about.
Here, buddy.
I know. I love it,
this
Cam.
Is, no, but this is so great. And it adds that little pop of color. Like you
yep.
say, I like how you said it's potpourri. It's like multi-sensory, right?
It the is
visual
multi-sensory.
Aspect. And then as we do this, by the way, I think I'm a natural.
Ooh.
I don't know what
Oh, my
to
God.
You
that
here.
Looks so beautiful, Cam. A plus, mister.
Wow. You
a
really
plus.
Changed your tune
okay.
a little bit since the last thing
you
I did.
Know, you impressed me. I give credit where it's due. Okay. Next step.
The scent.
Ah, yes.
The potpourri scent. It
okay.
smells amazing here, everybody.
All right.
You wish you could smell
it. Smell it. Okay.
But what do you got?
Here's what you do. Whenever you're going to make potpourri, you don't put the oil on the flowers to scent it. You're listening, right?
Yes.
You get roots of a plant. This is called valerian root. You can get it at the market health food store. And the reason why I chose this is going to absorb. Yeah, there's the plant. Believe it or not, those roots are going to go to work right now. So the roots are very porous. They've been dried. And so I'm going to go ahead and take some of my oil. And I have pumpkin spice.
As you do that, I just want to point out to people that this on itself.
Yeah.
The valerian, it
yeah.
smells amazing on itself, and I know it's a medicinal herb as well.
It is.
It's been used for centuries for calming and relaxation.
And that's why I want you to wake up. it's calming
it's
you down.
It's having an effect.
Okay, so what you can do, friends, Ooh. You can buy pre-blended. You can find these oils at the store. This one's pumpkin spice. Or you can mix your own. Here, I was gonna use cedar wood and sweet orange, but I do like the pumpkin spice. So when you do that, then you go ahead and you dump your oiled fixative, is what it's called, at the base of your dish, okay? And then now we can start assembling. And Cam, if you remember correctly, I said use the bulky stuff, pine cones.
Have you put the scent in yet?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, okay, good. I'm behind you.
I gave you too many compliments too quick.
Listen, potpourri for me is what I'm saying right here.
Let's get
I'm all for it.
We have cinnamon sticks. I have seed pods.
Okay.
Let's put some of our beautiful enhanced leaves. Look how pretty that is.
You know what I like about this, Cheryl?
What?
It looks beautiful. Be a great gift. And how do we make sure that we preserve the scent and the look of all this?
Okay. So once you finish making your beautiful work of art,
yes.
What you're gonna do, friends? Cover this with plastic, put it in a cupboard for about 2 weeks, and let it cure, let everything meld. And then when you bring it out, it's gonna be so beautiful. It's gonna be wafting through the air, and it will last a lot longer.
Okay, so I did really well with the coloring. I need a little help with
pretty.
The assembly. Oh, it does? Okay,
yeah.
Right.
Hey,
you know, I just have no idea. I mean, when I think I did a great job, it's lousy, and when I think I messed it up, it's fantastic.
It's better than mine.
You can't go wrong with potpourri. Get today's steps at HallmarkChannel.com. Shirley, you're amazing. Thank you
so much.
And make sure you go to Shirley's website as well.